This tutorial is going to explain how the dynamic effect templates work and how to interpret that list of templates so that you can use them with your dynamic effect playbacks. These templates do work in conjunction with the dynamic effect playback. So if you're unfamiliar with that concept, I recommend taking a look at the other tutorials in this series to understand that concept before looking into this one. Dynamic effect templates are used to define the mathematics that will be used in a dynamic effect. If you remember, a dynamic effect is simply math placed on a parameter so that it runs around a base point of some type. So for example, if you set the lights to 50% intensity, run a smooth dynamic effect on top of them, a sine wave is going to cause that intensity to move above and below the 50% point, creating a nice smooth intensity chase. So we'll step through that with some lights I've already got positioned and look at a pan-tilt effect, and we'll look at intensity effects as well. They're really not that difficult. So one place you can look is in the browser. If you arrow down to or touch the effects segment of the browser and open that up, you'll see the dynamic effects section. So here's the dynamic effects section of the browser, and you can see the very first item is the dynamic templates. I could open up this list right here and see all of those templates in the browser, or I can hit modify on dynamic templates or double click it, and I can see then a whole tab containing all that information. So each effect template has a number, it has a name, there's a listing of the parameters that that effect will run on, and then there's some default information about that effect. So if we look at the first effect template, it's for a clockwise circle, that's what the little arrow is indicating in the name. It's going to run on pan and tilt. And then these three settings, offset relation, delay relationship, and distance, are the default settings for that shape. And as you can see, they're pretty much the default settings for every shape in this list. When you choose this shape, those are the settings you're going to get on the effect playback, and then you can start adjusting from there. If you make a change at this level, every time you recall the circle, it's going to start off with those specific settings you have applied here in this list. So we're going to leave those alone for now. And we'll take a look at what a circle actually is. So a circle is a pan and tilt effect. When I hit modify on the parameters cell of the circle, I'm going to see all of the pieces of mathematics and how many parameters are actually involved in creating a circle effect. In here you can see there's just two parameters, a pan line and a tilt line. Each parameter is being given a sine wave to perform around whatever the base point is. And then in order to create the circle shape, you can see that the delay, offset, size, rate, and weight information might be different from one line to the next. That's going to create the relationship between pan and tilt in order to create a shape that we recognize as a circle. In this case, it's very simple. We leave pan alone. We offset tilt by 25%. And when we run this shape on top of our lights, we'll see a circular type shape running. Let's have a look at that. So I'm going to just close those out. I have my lights already positioned. I have them in a smaller iris so I can see them clearly on the stage. And I have them pointed at a position off the 50-50 point. This is important for circle effects because if you run a circle effect on a 50-50 light, it's probably going to run into its pan stop. And what that means is that the circle very quickly starts looking like a figure eight. So to see a circle clearly, you really need to point the light somewhere off of its home position. So I'll select effect number 21, which is a dynamic effect playback. And I'm going to choose from my channel source the type group. We're going to use group 1, which is convenient since it's already the first one in the list, but I could pick from any of the groups by using the film strip, or I could type the number of the group and touch that cell and it would go specifically to that group number. The circle template is also the first template in the list, which is convenient, but I could also open a film strip here and choose from among the 80 templates we have in the system. Or if I know the number, type the number, hit the dynamic template cell, and it would go straight to that definition. Offset relationship, delay relationship, and distance we'll leave the same for right now. The rate is the speed of the dynamic, we'll leave that alone for now. And the size scales to the intensity of the dynamic effect playback. So as I roll up the intensity on the playback, the circle will get bigger and bigger and bigger, up to our maximum size here of the full size of the effect. So I'll just start rolling that up. And you can see we've now got our 12 lights following each other around the middle person on stage. They're following each other because of the evenly spread offset relationship we've got set here with the template, or with the dynamic effect, that is. And as I play with these parameters, it will change the way this circle looks. Looking at this circle, you can see the lights are both panning and tilting, and that's what the template does. It's going to define the curve or the math that's going to be used on each of those two parameters in order to create what we recognize as a circle. Let's look at another dynamic effect really quickly, one that does, in fact, use the sine wave as well. But instead of using pan and tilt, we're going to run it on these same lights, and we're going to run the smooth intensity effect. So I've got these lights up at a level. They're not at full. See, there's full, there's zero. We're going to put them somewhere in between. And I happen to know that this template is number 13. So I'll type that and hit dynamic template cell, and I get the smooth effect. Once again, you could open the film strip and choose from there. And as I bring up this effect, now it's the same playback, just a different shape, I'm going to start seeing an intensity effect running. And this is just a way of using that same sine wave math, but on a different part of the light. In this case, it's running on intensity. The base point is this 50-ish percent that we've got running. And then the sine wave, as you watch, it's going to fade, if you think about from the middle point, it's going to fade the light to a higher position, up towards full, and then it's going to fade that light back down to zero, and then back up again. And that's how you get this nice, smooth on-off intensity effect. It's actually fading above and below the base point of 50% that we've set with the master fader. And then we'll take one more look at what's available, and that's going to be an on-mark, off-mark. So I'm going to open this up, and here's on-mark and off-mark. I'm going to choose that. And now you can see we get a very different behavior. It's not a nice smooth curve anymore. It's a snapping on and off type of effect, a blinking effect. This is an example of a wave that is more square shaped. So the light is off and then it snaps to an on position, stays on for a period of time, and then snaps off again. In this case, on mark means the lights are normally on and they drop out. If I choose the partner, off mark, you'll see they stay off and occasionally pop on, but they're snapping, they're not curving, they're not fading. And this is using a more square-shaped wave to create this particular dynamic effect. And we'll talk a little bit about how those waves can be created to create a snapping or a smooth effect in another tutorial video. And that is the basics of understanding how the math is applied to a parameter in order to create a dynamic effect.